Mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Good evening and welcome to this Sunday Eucharist on this Remembrance Sunday, but also the third Sunday before Advent. Christmas is drawing near towards us, the third Sunday before Advent. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Celebrate the presence of Christ in word and sacrament. Let us call to mind and confess our sins. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all these past, and grant that we may serve you in the newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. To restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of all. Govern the hearts and minds of those in authority, and bring the families of the nations divided and torn apart by the ravages of sin, to be subject to his just and gentle rule, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Alas for you who desire the day of the Lord. Why do you want the day of the Lord? It is darkness, not light, as if someone fled from a lion and was met by a bear, or went into the house and went rest of the hand of the Lord and was bitten by a snake. Is not the day of the Lord darkness, not light, and gloom with no brightness in it? I hate, I despise your festivals, and I take no dislike to your solemn assembly. Even though you offer me your burnt offerings and grain offerings, I will not accept them. And the offerings of well-being to your fleshed animals, I will not look upon them. Take away from me the noise of your song. I will not listen to the melody of your hearts. But let justice roll down my fortunes, and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, so that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. The Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds, together with them, to meet the Lord in the air, and so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore encourage one another with these words. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Paul didn't want the Christians in Thessalonica to be in any doubt about what had happened to their loved ones who had died. Because I know that there was some doubt. As there is often too, of course, with families who are grieving, what's happened to me? What's happened to my loved ones? The Thessalonians had joyfully received the message of Jesus' death and resurrection from the dead. And they were confident that Christ had conquered death, and their great faith had become an example through the whole of Macedonia, through the whole of Greece. They even stopped worshipping their idols, and they turned to the one true God, waiting for his Son, the risen Jesus, to return from heaven. But then, shock of all shock, the Thessalonian Christians started to die. And Jesus, whom God had raised from the dead, of course, had not yet returned. It would seem that they were under the impression it was going to be a quick return of Jesus. And therefore they'd become confused about what would happen to their loved ones who had died when it didn't happen. Would they then miss out on the return of Christ? Would they miss out on benefiting from the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead? And so St. Paul wants to end their confusion by assuring them that their dead will not miss out on any of those things. And it is this concern for the dead, the love of the dead, which has always been part of the Christian faith. From the earliest of times, Christians would continue to pray for the dead, as had been the custom among the Jews. And they prayed for them because they loved them. And even when the practice, of course, of praying for the dead was suppressed among some Christian traditions, as it is today, that basic Christian desire to pray for those who have passed away cannot entirely be squashed. And after the slaughter of the First World War, there came an even greater desire to pray for the dead again. So many people, as we know, died in that war, died terribly, that there was a great groundswell of charity to recover this ancient Christian practice for all of those who had fallen in that commitment to our nation. As we did here this morning, of course, in this Minster church, across the country, indeed, across the world. The message of Jesus had at its very center a message of love. And it was a message of love that crossed all boundaries. Jesus repeated the Old Testament command to love our neighbor. He made it very clear to us that we have to be very careful what limits we put on who our neighbours are. For one thing, he told us that we have to love our enemies, pray for those who persecute us. Even our enemies become our neighbours. And when someone asked him, well, who is our neighbour? Well, of course, he told them that wonderfully well-known story about the Good Samaritan, where it was the Samaritan, a foreigner, who helped that Jewish person who was in trouble. And it is through that parable and the other teachings of Jesus that ought to extend our view of who our neighbours are, and to include the whole of the human race, our enemies. enemies as well as our friends. And when it therefore comes to those who have died, we learn that they are also our neighbours. And that fundamental Christian instinct that we have to love our dead and to offer prayers on their behalf. No living human being lies outside our charity, and I can say to you, neither do our dead too. Today it is the dead of war who ask for our prayers. The dead who fought for our country, and indeed the dead who fought against it. All in God's eyes are our neighbours. And the faithful departed are just as much a part of the body of Christ as we are here who gather in this Minster church. In the Gospel appointed for today, we learn that the wise will be ready and prepared to meet Christ when he comes to meet us, both at the end of human history and when each one of us dies. And if we are wise, we will be ready to meet him. And the wise make themselves ready to meet Christ through love. It is not those who call out, "Lord, Lord," whom Christ will recognize. That's what it says. But those who practice love towards their neighbor. So on this Remembrance evening, remember not to put arbitrary limits on who we think our neighbors are. Be wise today, and of your charity, pray for the dead, that one day you will ask others to pray for you too. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Pray for our archbishops, Justin and Stephen, for our diocesan bishops,
We are the body of Christ. In the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body. Let us then pursue all that means for peace and builds up our common life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Our offertory hymn is hymn number 295. 295. And with all the company of heaven, We proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing. Same way after supper he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them saying, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. So, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread, and in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit. So that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. George, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. This bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Thank you. called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall redeem you. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen.
Amen.
peace, whose Son, Jesus Christ, proclaimed the kingdom and restored the broken to fullness of life. Look with compassion on the anguish of the world, and by your healing power, make whole both people and nations, through our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory.
Amen.
Be seated for a moment, please. There is some information on your weekly sheet that speaks of the deanery gathering on Monday the 27th of November, when the Bishop of Sheffield and some senior staff will be coming and visiting the deanery of Doncaster all day, and there is an event in the night that has some worship within it, but also an opportunity for people to share what is going on in their own parishes, where God is blessing us in what we do. There is some information at the crossing. If you are able to go or wish to know more information about that, there is a sheet there for you to take away that will give a bit more information, but it's on the weekly sheet for you. And if you feel you want to go to that, then you just go and turn up at St. James's Church. That's on Monday the 27th, as it says. We still need some help, if you can, for the Light Festival that is coming up. So if you think you can perhaps do a session or two, then there are again sheets at the crossing for you to sign up for some of those if you're able to do so. Rest assured, if you are here, there'll be others here too. You'll not be holding the responsibility for the place if you're here. But help is needed so that it doesn't fall on everybody. Those are the only things that are on this weekly sheet, but I actually want also now to say congratulations to Trevor and Mary, whose anniversary it is today. And this hymn that we are going to now sing, Love Divine, was actually sung at their wedding. So we're going to sing it with some gusto now as we congratulate you for your many years together. You must remind me how many years it is. 62. That's worthy of anybody's congratulations and praise and thanksgivings to God. So let's stand to sing our final hymn, Love Divine.
Thank you.
62 years ago as we sang that for you. Lovely. Can I also say a huge thank you to Andrew for singing for us this evening, and of course our musical director Darren, with the day that we have had here for Remembrance too. It was good that thank you for his play. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding. Keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.